So let's get back to our compiler. Again, in MatSet, I pulled out one more clause. This is a clause for a sequence, and this is what we return. If I want to write the compiler for that sequence clause, I would say, let's define sequence of XY. It's a compiler, so it's going to return a function that operates on X and Y, takes as input a text, and then returns the result. And we could take exactly that result. While I'm moving everything to this more functional notation, I decided, let's just show you a different way to do this. This way to do it would be fine. I could have the function return that, but instead, let's have it say, well, what we're really trying to do is form a union of sets. And what are the sets? The sets that we're going to apply union to, first, we apply X to the text, and that's going to give us a set of remainders. And for each of the remainders, we want to apply Y to it. So what we're saying is we're going to map Y to each set of remainders, and then we want to union all those together. Now, union, it turns out, doesn't take a collection, it takes arguments. We union A, B, C, and so we want to turn this collection into a list of arguments to union, and so we do that using this apply notation of saying, let's just put a star in there. And now we've got our compiler for sequence. It's the function from text to the set that results from finding all the remainders for X, and then finding all the remainders from each of those after we apply Y. And unioning all those together in union will eliminate duplicates. Now it's your turn to do one. This was the definition of alt in the interpreter MatSet. Now I want you to write the definition of the compiler for alt, take a pattern for X, Y, and return the function that implements that.